thanks a lot, you guys, for taking a few minutes with me. I really appreciate it.
Yeah.
I was at the world premiere of this at Sundance, and yeah, man, I've been to Sundance a lot of years, and it was one of the most fun screenings I've had in a while. I was telling Sunita and John earlier that it seemed like this movie was a real blast to shoot. Yes. Talk to me a little bit about how you came up with the story, first of all, and then how it was on set.
Yeah, the story was really exactly what the log line is, and it came out of a fear of being disconnected from technology and something really bad happening. You know, that's just kind of a natural fear that everybody has, right?
Yeah, Eleanor had the idea when she was upstate at a cabin with bad cell service. and then she was like, do you want to write this together? And I was like, yeah, that sounds great. We did it. And then we got like the best crew possible and John and Sunita together. And then it was just like upstate New York. Everyone's up there and having a great time. And it was kind of the best case scenario.
If you were at the premiere, you obviously a lot of the crew were at the premiere at Sundance too. And it truly was like just such a fun environment. I mean, it helps when you're doing a comedy, obviously, like everyone's having a good time, but John and Sunita especially just entertained everyone between every take. They were both so funny and it just really set a great tone for the show.
How closely would you say that you guys are to them? I mean, we all have that fear. Like I have that fear too. Like if I shut down for a minute, I think the world's going to blow up. So, I mean, how closely related to them would you say you guys are?
I mean, the first draft of the script was very much like ripped from our real life in terms of like the little idiosyncrasies about the characters. And then as it evolved, some of those things stayed. And then, a lot of them became more specific because you think about the film from a bit more of a plot standpoint or whatever, and you change things. And then obviously once we got John and Sunita involved, like you want to kind of manipulate it again to make it like more to their strengths or to like what makes sense for these characters that we're all now building together. It was there's a few things in there that are still us for sure. Little details.
How difficult of a shoot was this? Did you guys, it seems like you're kind of in your own little bubble out there too, kind of like the characters in the movie. You guys are kind of off in your own little world doing this. How difficult was the shoot?
It wasn't like as difficult as we've heard other shoots to be, because the crew was not only wonderful people, everybody who was invested in the movie, but they were also just like really sharp and fast. So we had kind of just a wonderful shooting experience. The producers were great. The hardest part was some of the special effects at the end of the movie, which are really complicated, because we did it all in camera.
That was really tricky. And also the weather just every day was like a dicey thing. We didn't realize at the time, but apparently it's a thing that it rains a lot upstate in June. So every day we had rain forecasts and our poor AD had to just like change the schedule.
Every
constantly.
Day we had to change the schedule.
It was like, okay, what are we going to shoot today? And
I think I remember you guys telling a story at the premiere about the effects at the end. And then I can't remember what that story was exactly. It slipped my mind.
We did it all with projected backgrounds instead of green screen.
Yeah, the whole movie is practical effects and like old school tricks and stuff. So it's like really fun to do, but we're doing it on like an indie scale, whereas usually that's done on a big Hollywood scale. So it's like a lot of problem solving.
Talk to me about the poofs, man. I mean, everybody's talking about the poofs. Were they based on tribbles, or were they just something you just kind of came up with? They're a great idea. They were a lot of fun in the movie.
The poofs are so big now. They just got signed to CAA. They're really
hoping they would send us like a swag box with a poof in it.
Oh, we got to do it.
Oh, see, I want one.
That's a mini one that our production designer made. But the idea was just like mostly, you know, to fit the decor of the cabin and something to be like disguised in that way. Definitely like once we got into it and started thinking about like how we were going to shoot it, obviously like critters, tribbles, you know, all these kind of throwback creature.
Like the furry version of gremlins. Yeah. These things. Cause we love all these movies and we wanted, like we got the chance to make a movie. So we wanted to shoot it like classic comedy style and then like classic creature movie style.
Yeah,
and we
so
got to
fun.
Do it all.
Well, this has been great, you guys. I'm happy I got a chance to see the movie and watch it again just the other day. I wish you the best of luck with it. And I can't wait to see what you guys do next.
Thanks so much. Thanks for making an appearance in the trailer too.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Yeah. You're right. I wasn't. That's true. Yeah. You guys didn't put me there. thanks a lot, you guys. I appreciate it. Stay safe.
You too.
All right. Bye.
See ya.